Hi students, we are going to start with a new chapter of history of class 9, that is the Vedic period. So first we will see what is the syllabus of this chapter. So the Vedic period sources, Vedas and epics, a brief mention, and iron autographs and pottery, a brief comparative study of early and later Vedic society and economy. So first we will see what is Vedic period. So the historian said that when Aryans came to India and they started a settled life, that first period of that settlement is known as early Vedic period. The arrival of Aryans and their beginning of life in India is known as the early Vedic period. Now why did they settle in India? The reason is here. Between 1000 BC to 500 BC, when iron had come to be used, it is believed that they began to make iron tools. They cleared forest and they started living on the river banks of river Yamuna and Ganga. Okay, they started a settled life. They cleared the forest and started a settled life on the river bank of river Yamuna and Ganga. Normally they lived a life of nomadic life. Gradually they settled in Gangetic Valley. So when they started a settled life, the beginning of their life in India is known as early Vedic period. Or when they started a settled life in India or near the river of Ganga and Yamuna, that period is known as later Vedic period. The culture of this period, so the beginning and end, early Vedic period and later Vedic period. So the period between early Vedic period and later Vedic period, the life or how the culture was. What is a culture? Culture means the lifestyle of a people is known as culture. So on what basis their life was? Their life was on the basis of Veda textbooks, Vedic text. That's why it is known as Vedic culture. Okay, they led a life based on the Vedas, Vedic books. So that's why it is known as Veda or Vedic culture. Clear? So now we will show the sources. Okay, first, already you might have learned in the previous classes about how could we know about the history. There are primary and secondary sources. So here also we have, so these Vedas are Veda books, Vedic books are primary sources to know about these people, Aryans, or the people of India. So first we will discuss about literary source. The Vedic text may be divided into two broad chronicle groups, the early Vedic text, when the most of the hymns of Rig Veda were composed, and the later Vedic text, to which belong the remaining Vedas and their branches. Okay, so early Vedic period, the main textbook, the four Vedas were composed, and its subsidiary books were composed in the later Vedic period. Two periods correspond to the two phases of Aryan expansion in India. The social, economic, political and religious aspects of life of the people came to be reflected in the Vedic culture. Thus Vedas became the storehouse of knowledge. So why it is known as Vedic culture? Already I said, the life of the people, it was based on the books Vedas. So what was the life based on? The life, the social life, economic life, political and religious aspects of life, it was completely based on the Vedic literature. That's why it is known as the Vedic culture. Thus we can say that Vedas became the storehouse of knowledge. It taught them how to live the life. Vedas taught the people how to live a life. So whatever aspects of life it may be. So it led them to live a normal or a good life. The Vedic culture was written in Sanskrit. The time Veda has been derived from the Sanskrit word vid, which means knowledge. So the Veda itself means what? The Veda, the word, Sanskrit word itself means knowledge. Vedic literature is divided into two parts, namely Shruti and Smriti. What is Shruti? Shruti means one that is heard. One that is heard from someone. So normally it is believed that Shruti, this knowledge, is given by God. So God said to the people, sannyasis, we can say God said to the sannyasis, that what is heard from the God. The God revealed it to the sannyasis. That is Shruti. And Smriti, what it is? What they heard, they recollected. Smriti, recollection. Remembering of the things. That is known as Smriti. Okay. The Vedic literature can be classified into the following categories. The four Vedas. That is Rig Veda, Sama Veda, Yajur Veda and Atharva Veda. And their Samhitas. And Brahmanas attached to each Samhita. The Aranyakas and Upanishads. So the Vedic literature can be classified into four. The Vedas, the Brahmanas and Aranyakas and Upanishads. Now we will see in detail what are Vedas. The Vedas, first one is, Vedas are four. Rig Veda, Yajur Veda, Sama Veda and Atharva Veda. What is Rig Veda? Rig Veda is the oldest religious textbook and the first testament of mankind. Can be said as the first testament, the first book about mankind. It is divided into 10 mandalas. It is 10 mandalas. It is said to have composed during the early Vedic period. The hymns are dedicated to the sages, dedicated by sages to God. That means they are praising songs. These are the songs, praising songs of gods. They were passed on orally from teachers to their disciples. That is what Shruti heard. It is orally passed from their gurus to disciples. The Rigvedic hymns are the authentic source of knowledge of the life of the people of the time. Much of the Indian philosophy is based on the Rigveda. It also contains the famous Gayatri Mantra. What is Gayatri Mantra? Have you ever heard of what is Gayatri Mantra? Gayatri Mantra is Om Bhu Bhuvasvaha Tat Savidur Varanyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi Diyo Yona Prachodaya. This is Gayatri Mantra. Okay. Although religious in nature, the Vedas are valuable source of information on various subjects. So I think what is Rigveda is clear. These are religious hymns. Now what is Samaveda? Samaveda is Sama means sweet, the melody. In this Veda, some of the hymns are borrowed from Rigveda. The hymns in Samaveda were meant to be sung at the time of sacrifice. When they offer pujas, when the priests offer pujas, they use the hymns from the Samaveda. So Samaveda is composed of songs which are usually sung at the time of sacrifice and pujas. Then Yajur Veda, what is Yajur Veda? It deals with the hymn recited during performance of Yajna. So these are the hymns used at the time of Yajnas. The hymns in this Veda throw light on the social and religious life of the Aryans. Then Atharva Veda. Atharva Veda, it is normally about the mantras. Mantra means the magic. Okay. The hymns contained in the Vedic deal with magic and charm. Most of the hymns are taken from the Rig Veda. Besides the powers of spirit, hymns deals with Gyan, knowledge, karma, action and upasana, invocation. Some hymns also deal with the medicine for the treatment of various diseases. Atharva Veda. So why it is Atharva Veda called? A part of this Veda is dealing with the black magic. We say black magic, the spirit. But some other part is dealing with the knowledge, karma and upasana. And some other part is dealing with the medicines for the diseases. Now, the second part we can say as, what are Brahmanas? Written after the Vedas as their simple commentary, the Brahmanas are in prose. They explain the social and religious importance of rituals as well as the value of sacrifice. The Brahmanas are a great historical value. Each Veda has several Brahmanas. Brahmanas, we can say it as, this is an explanation of Vedas. It's a commentary to Vedas. Okay. It is a commentary. So why this? Or in a Veda, there is a hymn is there. So what is the importance of this hymn? When it is recited? How it is recited? All the details regarding the Vedas are explained through the book Brahmanas. Clear? the explanation of brahmanas sorry explanation of vedas are known as brahmanas now aranyakas they are known as forest books written for the guidance of the hermits and the students living in forest they form the concluding part of brahmanas their main theme are mysticism and philosophy so aranyaka means it is forest okay so this is a guidelines for the people those who are living in forest especially hermits sannyasis and the students okay this can be called as a concluding part of brahmanas their main theme is mysticism and philosophy what is mysticism mysticism can be called as it's an idea beyond our knowledge or can be compared as the beliefs and philosophy the Upanishads they are philosophical commentaries on the Vedas the doctrines such as karma moksha maya are explained in detail the Upanishads form the basic source of Indian philosophy composed by different sages they are said to be from the foundation on which later additions to Vedic literature rest the most famous these Upanishads are Chandogya Upanishad Kena Upanishad Aitareya Upanishad and Taittiriya Upanishads so this is the philosophical commentary on various topics so vedas are explained about vedas explain about various things in our life so how to see how what is the philosophical value of all those things especially about karma moksha maya what is karma karma means what about our actions what is the philosophical view about it what is moksha the life after death the heaven the maya the finite things are in life so all these some of the important names are also given there what is Chandogya Upanishad Kena Upanishad Aitareya Upanishad and Taittiriya Upanishad then allied Vedic literature so to the Vedas some portions of or some literature works are added what are that the Vedangas what is they deal with the ways in which Vedas ought to be chanted and they are thus important in the understanding of the Vedas the six Vedangas deal with pronunciation grammar etymology metrics and astronomy so what are Vedangas Vedangas deal with the way how the hymns are chanted pronounced okay then their grammar etymology and metrics and astronomy then sutras what are sutras they are divided into three groups the Shraudha sutras which deal with the yajna and sacrifice the Grihya sutra or Smartha sutra which deal with the ceremonies connected with the family life and Dharma sutras which provide rules of conduct and various classes of people and religious stages in their life so only you need to know about this then Upavedas as the name suggests these subsidiary Vedas they are four in a number Ayurveda no it is Ayurveda it deals with medicines Dhanurveda describes the art of warfare art of fighting then Gandharva Veda describes about the art of music then Shilpa Veda is the art of architecture then Darshanas what are Darshanas there are six schools of Indian philosophy known as Shad Darshanas Shad means six Shad Darshanas they include Nyaya Darshana Vaisheshika Sankhya Yoga Purva Mimamsa and Uttara Mimamsa they all propagate the virtues of life and are opposed to external rituals okay then the dharma shastras the law books called dharma shastras dharma sutras and the smritis together with their commentaries are called dharma shastras the law books the books that deal with the laws okay and the smriti already we said what is smriti the written forms remembered and recollected and written that is called smriti okay and both these combined are known as dharma shastras they lay down the duties for different class of people so from this we can say that manusmriti is an example so what are the different caste the society was divided into four castes brahmana kshatriyas vaishyas and shudras so what brahmanas should do what kshatriyas should do and what vaishyas and what vaishyas and shudras should do all their duties were given okay manusmriti gives a description of hindu code of law including varnas the caste and ashramas the ashtadhyayi it is a treatise on sanskrit grammar by panini information is given about the roots of the words and conducts in which they are used in vedic literature ashtadhyayi means we can say it's a book written by panini we can say it is a dictionary okay where the veda the names okay the words that is used in Vedas and explanation of those words, how it originated, every details are given in known as Ashtadhyayi. Then next we will see the epics. What are the epics? The Ramayana and Mahabharata. Ramayana. The Ramayana was originally composed in Sanskrit. The Sanskrit version is said to be the work of Maharshi Valmiki. So you know what is the story regarding Ramayana. So I think I need not explain about the story of Ramayana. It is about Lord Rama and his wife Sita and brother Lakshmana. The life related to it. Okay. Then what is Mahabharata? Mahabharata believed the work of sage of Vyasa. Mahabharata is written in Sanskrit. Originally it is called Jaya. Was a collection dealing with the victory. Subsequently it came to be known as Bharata because it contains the stories of descendants of the king Bharata. The finally completion came to be known as Mahabharata. The important part of Mahabharata is known as Bhagavad Gita. Okay, and it is considered the most religious text. Okay, and what is explained in this Mahabharata? The interest of the self might conflict with the duty. So our interest, there is a conflict always. Our interest and our duty. Our duty may not support always our interest. And this is the answers. Bhagavad Gita is the answer to the questions raised by Arjun by Bhagavan or Lord Krishna. Okay. And it is explained, Bhagavad Gita explains about the various philosophy about life, the duty, karma, etc. Okay. What is the importance of these epics? Epics serve as the main source of information on the political institutions and the social and cultural organization of the epic age. So when we read these epics, we could know that what way of life the people lived, what was the social situation, what was the religious situation, or what was the what was the social information, all the social and cultural organization about the people we get. And they provide information on various Aryan kingdoms, their armies, weapons they used. Kshatriyas were interested with the defense of their kingdoms and they believed that death on the battlefield was noblest act of in the life of a warrior. The epic was are considered as the finest literary works of the ancient period and are acclaimed for their literary and philosophical value. So the epics can be considered as the great works because the philosophical value and the literary value, we cannot compare with those any books that is written after us. Okay, these are great books. They reveal the high ideals of family life of the Aryans. Their great heroes depicted in the epics are the embodiment of the high moral principles and made by the impact of successive generations. The Bhagavad Gita elaborates the karma philosophy and immortality of the soul. And what is Bhagavad Gita explained here? So I think the part is very clear for you, and we discussed about this, what is early Vedic period, later Vedic period, then we discussed about the Vedas and the Aranyakas, then Brahmanas and the epics. Okay, so you please read the textbook and you go through the video. If there is any doubt, we will clear it. Dear students, so there was a comment in the last video. Because of first chapter, I left 4 answers. That is from 12 to 14, 15. So here it is given here very clearly. You please go through the answers and you can write it in your notebook. I think the first chapter notes are completed by this. So next class I will give the answer of the second chapter. You please see these answers and write in your copy.